What's going on, guys? It's Jaguar here. So today we're doing a review on the custom zombies map Bunker 10 in Black Ops 3. So if you somehow don't know what this map is, it's a map with different layers, or levels I guess you can call it, by Mad Guys Gaming, but it has several other people who helped make each different room. So this map features lots of guns, and many of those guns that it features are guns from Modern Warfare Remastered. So that's mostly a very good thing for most people, because it replaces all the Black Ops 3 weapons that you use over and over again in most maps, with like all the new Modern Warfare maps, and there's lots of variety in what to choose from. It also features weapons from Black Ops 2, not as many as there are Modern Warfare Remastered guns, but there's quite a few Black Ops 2 guns if you like any of them. This map has two new wonder weapons, and the first one are the Zigs, I think from League of Legends, that's what I heard. And then also it features the Lightning ZL1. They're both pretty crazy, and the Lightning ZL1, it's this crazy overpowered, almost like an SMG. But it has this little girl sitting on top of it, and it reloads your gun, and it kind of speaks to you. It's weird. And then the Zigs are, I don't even know what they are. It's like this little guy on top of a bomb, and you just throw the bombs. It's weird. So this map has its own power-up, which I think is really cool, because I haven't seen, custom power-ups before in Black Ops 3 Zombies. And basically what it doesn't even really have a name, I don't think. It's a duck. And when you pick it up, it says, "I am that duck," from Revelations. And so basically, once you pick it up, it has three things that it can give you. It can give you triple point, a free perk, or it can give you God mode for 30 seconds, which is pretty crazy. So yeah, I just wanted to throw that out. It's a little feature, but it's pretty cool. I enjoy it. This map has three new perks featured in it. It has Banana Colada, Mad Guys Moonshine, and Perk-A-Lot. So, I'm sure you guys all know what Banana Colada is. When you slide, it leaves this little, slippery trail, and zombies fall and die and stuff. The Mad Guys Moonshine, I'm pretty sure when you slide, it makes an explosion, and it kills some of the zombies around you. So it's basically, PhD 2.0. And Perk-A-Lot, it's not really a new perk, it just gives you all the perks in the game, so it's basically a perk-holic. Pretty much the last thing for the pro side of things, I guess you can call it, it's the amount of detail and little features that make the map that much better. It has so much detail to the map. If you go into the Shunonuma, I don't even know how to say it, but when you go into that room, you think it's like a real Treyarch map, that they made the map for them. And it's just amazing amount of detail. And it has just a lot of little funny, cool features in it. It has swimming. I thought that was a pretty cool feature. When you go to the cave room, you can swim through the cave, and it has a little water pool. And it's pretty cool. Lots of detail in it, and I really appreciate that he added all this stuff. So now, sadly, we're pretty much moving on to the cons of the map. So the first thing, the map's pretty difficult, and I have trouble getting around the map, opening the doors, and it's just kind of a hardish map. The doors are pretty expensive once you get into the higher layers or levels of the map, and I have trouble getting through the map. And there's not many guns on the walls. You only come across a wall weapon every few rooms. If you get lucky, you can get a box in some of the earlier rooms, but usually the box is in one of the later rooms that kind of are hard to get in there in the first place. And on top of that, there are a few bugs in the game. There's barriers where zombies can't even hit you. I've run into about two death barriers, I think, and it's kind of annoying. It's in a lot of rooms, it's kind of laggy, or really laggy in some cases. I mean, for the most part, it's alright, but it gets kind of annoying when you're trying to train in a room and it's laggy. But yeah, so there's a few problems, but overall, I think the map's pretty good. And yeah, so now for my rating, I would rate it about an 8.5 out of 10. It's a very good map, but there are rooms for improvement. Just little fixes that I can do. But yeah, tell me what you think in the comments, and I want to hear what you guys think. Because I can understand a 9 too, because, I mean, the map is pretty good. There's only very few bugs and stuff that they need to fix. But yeah, that's going to be the video. I'm going to wrap it up. Hope you guys have a great new year. And yeah, I'll see you later. Peace.